Hey everybody, how's it? Good morning. Okay, back with Primus. I only did one Primus, and it was called Tommy the Cat. And now I've decided to do, from some suggestions that came through, and I just thought it was funny, because in my head, sense of humor, if we do Tommy the Cat, maybe we should do Too Many Puppies. I'm curious, you know, to hear what this is going to be about. You know, you guys leaving your comments about the musicians in these bands, like, you know, in this case, Les Claypool and everything, puts me on such a learning journey on so much impact that a lot of these incredible musicians make on other bands, you know, whether they collab or they completely build another band, you know, like Maynard does with Tool and Pussifer and Perfect Circle and stuff, and the influence of their musicianship on budding musicians of that instrument, in this case maybe bass or guitar or drums and stuff. And you know, there's, you know, people such as this, I know I'm getting a little long-winded here, but I promise I'll be short-winded in the breakdown. The influence that these musicians make on younger musicians who are moving up and showing their abilities to be diversified, you know, to play in different kind of bands, different kinds of showing off different kinds of genres of music they enjoy playing, you know, to me that's really just super cool, and it's really eye-opening and really motivating. Even for me as an old composer, you know, I've been doing this since The Last Supper, and you know, I still, when I listen to that, I can still get motivated and want to pick up my bass or guitar or turn on my, you know, keyboards and stuff. So I really appreciate that, and that actually, that appreciation comes from you guys leaving your comments about them. So thank you so much. Anyhow, let's do this. Primus, Thomas the Cat. No. Anyhow, you know the jam. These videos don't monetize my channel. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, that link will be down below. It helps me what I do with the kids. And Primus, Spotify, and merch links will be down below. And the headsets, AKG 240s, that link will be down below too. All right, let's do this. Too Many Puppies by Primus. All right. This is hilarious. Not hilarious in a funny way, but in such a creative, rhythmical way. The rides that are being opened up with, at first I had to listen to them really, really, really close, but those are some beautiful ride bells. I don't know what symbols that he's using on that. They sound fantastic, but you know, that's it feels like the pure use of the overheads that are actually giving us that signal. Just from my old days of engineering live drums, you know, I never put, you know, mics on cymbals. You know, the cymbals and all of that were always picked up by, you know, these overheads, because we wanted that larger ambient kind of vibe to it. Doesn't mean it doesn't happen, but I love that, and the sound of it is so crispy and stuff that I had to double think. I go, it's a cymbal bells. The bass, you know, that really ominous kind of vibe. The setup for me was like, I imagined, because Theater of the Mind kicks in for me when I listen to music, and I imagined like some burglar sneaking around, you know, going from one side of the room to the other, you know, going to break in and go get that big gem, and that was what that vibe was to me. Because like I said, with music for me, it paints images in my mind, Theater of the Mind, that's why I'm bobo the way I am, and I I'm a ventriloquist and I have many voices in my head. But that's what it felt like. And then that ominous da 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 da. And then I love the percussive arrangement with the guitar. So it's a percussive arrangement because it's just him hitting the strings and then using the wah-wah pedal. So that kind of gives you in this kind of like ominous head bobbing kind of move and stuff. And then they come in with the power following that da-da-da-da-da. But what's really cool is the space they create for the melody, which is very unique. The lyrics, I'm catching them, and you know I don't normally listen to lyrics, but you can't help it when everything just drops out. And then it's back to this, you know, that cymbal pattern, and he's saying too many puppies, you know, so on and so forth. So I thought that was really super cool. I love the space that's being created for that performance, and I love his voice in this. Now, this is my second Primus track, so I don't know if I've got to definitely, you know, listen through. But if that is, you know, that Tommy the Cat and then this kind of vocal performance, super entertaining, but with this powerful, powerful rock riffiness behind it and stuff. So let me go back a skosh. All right.
Too many puppies I talk to heal. Too many puppies I train to kill. I make a man not man wearing my defensive ideas.
Okay, obviously we're going to go into a change here. Two things that I wanted to pull out of that last passage. Now, as an engineer, I probably would have gone mental to try to pull out the pops that when he says too many puppies. And, you know, since you are the pure listener, most of you, a lot of times you may have seen in videos now that we have YouTube and stuff when people sing and there's a windsock in front of them, you know, kind of a little circular thing. Back in the old days, you'd make that out of a hanger and nylons, you know, like in the 70s if you didn't have a windsock. And that prevents that sound. And at first I was like going, why wouldn't they have? And then I realized, be it a decision or not, it didn't bother me. It was just a nuance that I was just used to maneuvering to try to roll off that popping sound. But then I realized that's actually part of the percussive nature of his performance. Do many pop. Puppies and stuff. And it wasn't so that, because a lot of times when peas pop, there is a high, super high spikiness to it, but there's a bigger at the bottom that could really be super intrusive. But in this case, it was shaped, or it feels like, or I don't know, of course, but it feels like it was shaped to actually still be part of the performance. And it was like, I could probably see other guys in the studio going, no, leave it in, man. It's just completely cool. And then that last passage there where they did a little bit of the change up here for the, I want to say the solo expression section here, because it really sounded like just really experimental, kind of Hendrix-y kind of solo kind of work. It did have phrasing and stuff to it, but it was just like this kind of psycho movement through and stuff like that. And so I really, really super dug that little section there. And of course, that's a lot of whammy bar work and everything. So let me scooch back.
Thank you.
God, I love where there was that big ass section where they just let the drums light up. And, you know, that, I think it was probably, was it four bars? One, two, three. Let me four measure that up. Something, he was going off, and that sounded great. Something else I want to point out really quick before I dig out. Funny, I was just talking about that end of that kind of psychedelic Hendrix-y kind of solo vibe and the whammy bar. And little did I know that they were actually going to use the nuanced sound of that whammy bar for that that breakdown. And you can hear when the whammy bar is down that the tension of the strings have dropped. Obviously, that's what a whammy bar does for those of you who are pure listeners. That little bar that's at the side of the guitar, it bends it down, it brings the tone down, or it can bring it up if it's pulled up. Or sometimes you see musicians actually hit it and it gives it a kind of a vibe to it. In this case, sounds like he's got it down and he's holding it down and allowing the strings to resonate, a little vibration going there, because you could hear the tension of, or excuse me, the lack of tension as the whammy's down, and you can hear the string kind of, I don't know, guitar players help me out on what you might call that, but when the string is like kind of hanging in there and just wants to resolve and be straightened out, but you can hear the chattering of the strings a little bit. Something else I want to bring up too before I dig out is what I love about the engineering is that the drums were really super tight. And what I mean by that is there was, it sounded like there was zero ambience on the drum outside of the cymbals, the overheads. So I'm sure that every, you know, the snare had its, you know, mic set and its hi-hat and kick and toms and stuff, but there was no ambience on it, ambience or reverb or room or reflection or anything on it. And, you know, the bass carrying the bottom end of the tonal spectrum, and then the guitars powering out. The point I wanted to make was all of that was fairly dry. There wasn't anything on it, but they had the reverb on the vocals. So I really kind of dug that. And that changed the intimacy. Where was the vocals were placed? And then finally about the mix. When the holes were created for too many puppies, whatever, there was that he's placed in the mix perfectly in that. However, it feels like once the power and the everything came in, that they didn't move his vocal up in the mix to match where it was in that quieter spot. So quieter spot, you really heard his voice. As soon as the power came in, it sounded like his voice sunk back, but it seems like they just left it right there, the fader right at that same spot, and then just let the that ominous, blah, 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 you know, just go ahead and power hard left, right, and still kind of wrap them up in a little bit, you know, wrap them up that way a little bit. But I really dug this song. This definitely had kind of like that I'm coming to get you kind of vibe, that kind of thing. But like I said, I'm still sticking to the bank robber thing that I said earlier on. Anyhow, I hope you found this entertaining. Sometimes I hear myself talking, I go, damn boy, you gotta stop with the cups of coffee. Go surf in the morning first, get a cup of coffee, and then do a video. And maybe I'll just be more like, hey, what's up? Okay, music. All right, guys, take care. Aloha. All right.